The output voltage of an op-amp is given by the open loop gain times the difference between the input pins. The value of the open loop gain is designed to be very big. If, for example, 5 volts is connected to the non-inverting input and the inverting input is 0 volts or ground, then the output voltage will be very big according to the MOF. But remember that the output voltage can never be bigger than the value of the positive supply voltage. If we in another example connect 1 volt to the non-inverting input, but 2.5 volts on the inverting input, the MOF will tell us that Vout will be very negative. But remember that the output voltage can never be lower than the value of the negative power supply. The second parameter is about that in an ideal world, no current flows in or out of the inputs of the op-amp. This means, in other words, that these inputs are high impedance. In reality, this current is very small, but still small enough for the impedance to be high. The essence is that an operational amplifier does not load the circuitry you attach it to. In other words, the input voltage stays unharmed. The third parameter is that in an ideal world, a lot of current can flow in or out of the output of the op-amp. This means that the output is low impedance. In reality, this current is limited because otherwise the op-amp might explode. But the essence is that the output of an op-amp is allowed to be loaded heavily, and the output voltage will stay unharmed. Why is this useful? We'll take an op-amp buffer for example. I'd like to call buffers copy machines for voltage, because they take the input voltage and present a copy of it at the output. This copy of the voltage can be loaded with another circuit without harming the voltage at the input of the op-amp. The essence is that sensitive circuits can be chained together with buffers, and this way they don't interfere with each other.